Hey everyone, I'm Terry G. Thanks a lot for stopping by. This is an alcohol-free life channel where we learn to live sober one day at a time. If you can take a second, can you please hit the subscribe button, take another second, and smash that like button. I'd really appreciate it. Again, thanks a lot for stopping by. What I want to talk about briefly is step 9 in Alcoholics Anonymous. And why I want to talk about it a little bit, I've done video before, I want to talk a little bit more about it because I've had some comments on my YouTube channel about step 9 and people feeling overwhelmed. Just be rest assured that step 9 is a very difficult step for most of us. It really is. It's probably the most difficult step next to step 1, next to quitting the alcohol. If you found step 4 and 5 difficult and scary, step 9 can be like that too. But I just want to tell you, it doesn't have to be scary. It doesn't have to be overwhelming or create anxiety with you. It really doesn't. Okay? Because I'm going to let you in on something. The result that you're going to get from doing a good test step 9 is going to be great. It's going to be very positive on your emotional and mental well-being. And because of that, physically, you're going to feel better too, believe it or not. It's just basically a step making amends to people that we have harmed in our drinking. The things that we've done in our drinking that we've come to the conclusion from step 8 and all the prior steps that we need to make amends to these people, okay? And the reason the step is there at step 9, because by now, we're more likely well-grounded with our spirituality, we're well-grounded in the program of Alcoholics Anonymous. We're more likely active, we've read the book, we have a sponsor, and we may even have sponsees at this time, okay? That is quite possible too, because I know I had a sponsee before I reached step 9, believe it or not. So we're well grounded in our program, and we understand the process by now. We understand what we're trying to do, or what we're trying to accomplish by doing a step 9. It's going to complete the cycle. The garbage that we are carrying around in us, the guilt, the shame, the anger, the resentment, the hurt from past events that has happened in our lives, step 9 completes the cycle. You know, the alcoholism, the occurrence that caused us the resentment, the people we're resentment about, the amends that we have to make, it just completes a complete circle and it stops those thoughts or that negativity in our lives, what we've been thinking about in its tracks. And we've heard in the program that we feel reunited with mankind. We feel whole again in recovery, and step 9 really has a lot to do with that. But before you do a step 9, let me tell you something. You wanna make sure that you do a thorough step 8, and every amends that you make in your 9, you wanna talk to your sponsor or somebody in the program that has experience in the 12-step program and go over each and every amends before you make it. And the reason I'm telling you this, because it'll help you understand why you're making the amends. It'll take the fear out of the amends. And believe it or not, sometimes the amends that we think we need to make, we don't really have to make. Sometimes there's situations that were done to us and our reaction to that situation was completely appropriate, but because we're under the influence of alcohol, because we feel so much guilt and shame, we think we owe them an amends because maybe we overreacted or something. But that's another reason you talk to your sponsor. And like I explained in another video, I'll put it up here, step 8, we do the amends in 3 columns. The ones we'll do right away, the ones we'll do later, and the ones we'll never do. There's people we'll never find, the people who have passed away. We put it in 3 columns. So what you want to do is, for lesser words, start off with the easier ones, the ones you feel a little more confident and a little more at ease doing, and put those in your first column. Call the people up, sit with them, and make amends to them. And don't try and control the outcome of that amends. Most people will be happy that you're there. They'll be happy that you're cleaning up your life, and they'll be overjoyed that you took the time and effort to come back and talk to them about something that you did in the past and you want to apologize for. Most people are very open-minded, they're very happy and joyful, and they feel great that you have come to them to make an amends, and most of them will cheer you on in your journey of recovery. That's what happened to me. And I was overwhelmed and I was very afraid to do a step one. But the outcome of that step nine was overwhelming. It was overwhelming. I was walking on cloud nine. But there's another angle I want to talk about in step nine, just briefly, is when it'll harm others, it says in our step. When making amends will harm somebody. So if you have an ex-wife or a boyfriend or somebody that you're crazy with, like myself, I was very abusive, I was violent at time, maybe making amends to them won't be, you know, the right thing to do. But that's something you have to talk to your sponsor about, okay? Something that you have to talk to your sponsor about. So that's all I wanna talk about step nine. I put another video up here about step nine I did in the past. You might wanna review that one. And the one I put on step eight, you wanna review that. But the main thing in step nine is to become willing to do an amends and become open. I've been in the program 30 years and I'm still making amends for things that happened 35 years ago. People I run into on the bus or just through my daily life, I make that amends to them. So amends really doesn't end. It's continuous because some of those people, we don't know where they are, but we'll run into them maybe one day and you can walk up to them. They'll know who you are and you can make an amends to them. Okay? But don't get yourself overwhelmed with the expectation of the outcome or finding the people or how to do it. What you need to do is you need to keep an open mind, be willing to make the amends, take the action, that's really important, and talk to somebody who knows how to do a proper step nine and go over each and every amends that you're going to make before you make it. That's very, very critical, believe it or not. It really is, okay? So get out there, do it. It doesn't have to be perfect. But just go out and do it. Do the best you can. And remember, the amends is for you, not for them. So if they come at you nasty, that's on them. If they come after you and they're still mad about something you've done 25 years ago, that's on them. You are there to clean up your side of the street, to say amends for what you have done and apologize for what you have done in the past and take responsibility for your behavior while you drank and drugged, okay? So that's it, folks. Step nine is a great step. You'll be walking on sunshine after you do it, believe it or not. It'll let go of that past. It'll resolve the past. It really will. It'll help you do that, okay? My name is Terry G. This is an alcohol-free life channel where we're learning to live sober one day at a time. You can take a second, leave a comment. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to hit that like button, but don't forget to remain sober another 24 hours in your life. Okay, ciao for now. I'll see you next week. And remember, sobriety is freedom. Sobriety is freedom, okay? Ciao for now. Bye-bye. Thanks for stopping by.